Video, we are going to discuss about Carnot cycle. Carnot cycle is a thermodynamic cycle that gives the best efficiency possible. The Carnot cycle is named after the French engineer N.L. Sadi Carnot, who proposed it in 1824. Now we see the definition of Carnot cycle. It is an ideal heat engine cycle in which the working substance goes through the four successive operations of isothermal expansion and adiabatic expansion, isothermal compression and an adiabatic compression back to its initial state. Now we see the details of Carnot cycle. Let us consider the cylinder having frictionless piston contains n number of gas molecules. It is important to keep in mind that the Carnot cycle is reversible, that is, at every point defined in the PV diagram, the system is at equilibrium. This is the initial position of the gas molecule represented as 1, its initial pressure is P1 and its initial volume is V1. Now the system is expanded at constant temperature. To maintain the constant temperature, the system is absorbed heat from the surrounding. This is called isothermal expansion. Because of the system does work on the surrounding, it comes to the second position. Here the pressure is decreased from P1 to P2 and the volume is increased from V1 to V2. This is a constant temperature, it's a high temperature. Q2 is the heat absorbed by the system. The work done by the system in an isothermal expansion is equal to minus W1 is equal to nRT2 ln V2 by V1. Now the cylinder is thermally insulated, so no heat is exchanged between the system and the surrounding. Then the piston is expanded, so the gas molecules experiences adiabatic expansion and its position make as 3. Here the pressure and volumes are P3 and V3. The work done for an adiabatic expansion is equal to minus W2 is equal to minus NCV T2 minus T1. For an isothermal and an adiabatic process, the work done values we already discussed in the previous videos. Next, the thermal insulation is removed. Now the piston undergoes an isothermal compression, so the heat is being rejected from the system. As the piston compresses, work is being done on the system and therefore is increasing the internal energy of the system. An increase in internal energy is closely associated with an increase in temperature. However, the temperature of the system is the same because heat is flowing out of the system, that is to the sink. This heat is equivalent to the work done to the system. Now its position is 4. Here the pressure and the volumes are P4 and V4. Here the work done value, that is in an isothermal compression, the work done is W3 is equal to nRT1. ln V4 by V3. Here the heat is rejected from the system, so it is represented as minus Q1 at T1 temperature. Now again the cylinder is thermally insulated. Now the system undergoes an adiabatic compression, so work is done on the system by the surrounding. The work done is NCV T2 minus T1. After completing the adiabatic compression, it comes to its original position. So the process completes one cycle. Now we have all the work done values for the successive process. Now we calculate the net work done by the gas. For this, we have to sum the four work done values, that is minus W1 minus W2 plus W3 and plus W4. Substituting this minus W1 value and minus W2 value and W3 value and W4 values. Now we cancel out minus W2 and plus W4. Next we have NRT2 ln V2 by V1 plus NRT1 ln V4 by V3. By inverting V4 by V3, we get negative sign in between NRT2 ln V2 by V1 and NRT1 ln V3 by V4. Generally, for an adiabatic expansion of an ideal gas, Cv ln T2 by T1 is equal to R ln V3 by V2. This is for an adiabatic process, that is the process from 2 to 3. Similarly, Cv ln T2 by T1 is equal to R ln V4 by V1. This is for an adiabatic compression, that is a process from 4 to 1. Here the left hand sides are equals, so we equalate the right hand side. We get R ln V3 by V2 is equal to R ln V4 by V1. We cancel R ln R ln. We get V3 by V2 is equal to V4 by V1. Interchanging V4 and V2, we get V3 by V4 is equal to V2 by V1. We know that W is equal to this equation. Here we substitute V2 by V1 instead of V3 by V4. We get a new equation. Simplifying this equation, we get net work done value. That is W is equal to NRT2 minus T1 ln V2 by V1. Now we calculate the net heat absorbed by the system. Q is equal to Q2 minus Q1. We know that Q2 and Q1 value. Substituting these values, we get this equation. Introduce V2 by V1 instead of V3 by V4. We get this equation. Simplifying this equation, we have Q is equal to NRT2 minus T1 ln V2 by V1. That is, work done by Carnot engine is equal to the amount of heat absorbed by the system. So in Carnot engine, W is equal to Q. If N is equal to 1, the work done value will be RT2 minus T1 ln V2 by V1. Q2 value we know that. Now we define the efficiency of heat engine. It may be defined as the ratio of total work done by the system and heat absorbed. Mathematically, it is represented as W by Q2 is equal to RT2 minus T1 ln V2 by V1 divided by RT2 ln V2 by V1. Now we cancel out the common terms. We get ETA is equal to W by Q2 is equal to T2 minus T1 divided by T2. Or otherwise, we can write ETA is equal to Q2 into T2 minus T1 divided by T2. Now, we simplify this equation. We get 1 minus T1 divided by T2. It is clear that T2 minus T1 divided by T2 is always less than 1. Hence, efficiency of heat engine is always less than 1. No heat engine has been so far constructed which can show an efficiency equal to unity. Thank you.